creating awareness around the topic of fentanyl and fentanyl poisoning. So my essential question is, what are the steps to educate the Mills High School community about fentanyl and the dangers of fentanyl poisoning? So here's my outline. I'm going to be getting into my inspiration, choosing a mentor, the actual research, planning out my project and how I'd like to share it with people. My second mentor, I had two mentors, and I'll get into that later. Creating my project, presenting my project, what went well and what didn't, and then the impact it could have on the future. So what inspired me? I did lose a friend. She's up here. She was one of my coworkers. We were co-counselors together at summer camp. She wasn't a regular drug user. She wasn't a big risk taker. She took a Percocet that she thought was safe, and it was laced with fentanyl. She passed away April 2020 at the age of 15. She's not the only story that you'll hear of. I've seen many more stories of fatal teen overdoses involving fentanyl. This is because it's becoming so prevalent throughout the country, and especially in the Northeast, and a lot of people don't know that. In the beginning of the year, I talked to some of my friends and just people in the school about what they knew about fentanyl, and I was surprised that many people don't know the potency of fentanyl. So fentanyl is actually up to 50 times stronger than heroin and up to 100 times stronger than morphine. So it really only takes a tiny amount to cause a fatal overdose, and that's a clear picture of how much can kill a grown adult. Fentanyl is also undetectable. You can't see it, smell it, or taste it. The only way to detect whether or not there's fentanyl laced in drugs is with fentanyl test strips, and even those can be hard to get your hands on. Right here's a picture of an authentic oxycodone and a fake oxycodone. So they look identical. You can't tell the difference. Many street pills nowadays are counterfeit, and a lot of those counterfeit pills actually contain fentanyl. So these are just some things that I found people didn't really know about. So why I felt there was a need for this. Many teens are just unaware of what fentanyl is and fentanyl poisoning. It's undeniable. Teens experiment with drugs all over the country and experiment with drugs in Dallas. Nowadays, drugs are easily purchased. As long as you have a phone, it's really easy to contact someone through social media, get it through a friend or a friend of a friend. And oftentimes, they believe that they're buying something safe because they could be told that, but in reality, there's no way of knowing for sure. So my first mentor, after my senior project proposal, Mr. Abdiki recommended me to contact Amy Leone. She is a town social worker and a licensed mental health counselor and recovery coach at Chris's Corner in Milford, which is just a recovery resource. As you can see, she has some amazing credentials. The only thing was her work is more focused on substance abuse and helping people with addiction, helping people affected by it. And my project was more specific to fentanyl and fentanyl poisoning. So where we were coming from didn't exactly align, so I decided I would be better off just researching on my own and like seeing where that took me. So the actual research, I wanted to know where it was coming from. So the chemicals used to create fentanyl are mainly produced in China and then are sent to Mexico, and Mexican drug cartels then bring those drugs up to the US and distribute them all over the place. There's a major drug trafficking route that goes up from Mexico and takes a sharp right towards New York and the New England states. How and why is more present? Fentanyl is actually really, really inexpensive to make. It's cheaper than heroin, so that leads to more profit for these drug businesses and drug cartels. It's extremely potent and highly addictive, like I said. Those who don't die from fentanyl end up being very heavily addicted and keep coming back for more. So these drug businesses are creating a base of repeat customers. I've drawn a picture here. All six New England states are actually ranked in the top 15 for highest fentanyl-related death rate throughout the whole country. So I thought that was really, really alarming. New Hampshire is number one, and Massachusetts is actually number three. Learning about other stories. So I've seen many articles, videos, websites dedicated to the victims of fentanyl poisoning. I've seen a lot of loved ones trying to spread awareness about this epidemic. This is just a picture of some people that have lost their lives due to fentanyl. That's exactly what I'm trying to do here, just spread awareness. As I was continuing with my research, I wanted to add information on Narcan. So Narcan is a nasal spray that can rapidly reverse the effects of an opioid overdose. Anyone can use it, anyone can administer it, so I thought that was really important to add. I also wanted to add info on how to detect whether or not someone is experiencing an overdose. That way people are prepared in emergency situations. I thought really deeply about the best way I wanted to share my information with students, so I decided I would make a video. I wanted to include all my research, but not sound preachy like I was lecturing people. I wanted it to be very clear and like I was talking to them personally. I looked specifically for eye-catching visuals and a couple of great short videos that I inserted. So my video is actually a slideshow with some pictures and a voiceover, but it's made out to be one continuous video that I just played. Second mentor, Mr. Finney, he, as you all know, he's the Millis High School Athletic Director, and he's also the health teacher. I talked to him about what he speaks about in his class, and I took his health class freshman year, so I know that he has an opioid unit and drug unit, but they don't specifically talk about fentanyl, so I thought that was a really, really good opportunity to discuss presenting in his class. So I had to teach myself how to make a video. I never used Movie Maker before. My dad offered the idea, but I ended up doing pretty much everything on my own. I wanted to make the video pretty short and concise. It ended up being about 8 minutes long, which was I found was pretty ideal. Presenting in the health class. So I presented in Mr. Finney's period 1 and period 5 on 2 separate days. I just introduced myself, played the video. I tried to encourage some questions from these students, and since his classes were pretty small, I thought about other ways I could reach a larger audience, and that the perfect way to do that was through Senior Project Day, presenting in the auditorium. May 5th, 2023, it was a much larger audience, so grades 9 through 12 had the opportunity to come to the auditorium and watch my video. So basically almost the entire school saw my video, and I played it. It was played 6 times, 2 times in the Finney's health class, and then 4 times on Senior Project Day. So a lot of people had the opportunity to see it. What went well? I'm very pleased with my video. I thought it was effective. I got a lot of really, really good feedback on it. I can also think that it can be used in the future. And since I did my project on fentanyl, and it's so common nowadays, I was able to find a lot of information on it. So that was also helpful. What did not go well? I ended up doing the bulk of my project on my own, which I know you're supposed to do the senior project on your own, but there were times where I did kind of wish that I had a little bit of extra support here and there. I would have picked a mentor in the school from the start. It would have been much easier to schedule meetings and just come up with ways to meet if they were actually present in the building. As I was editing, I was kind of like thinking to myself, I should have talked to Ms. Mannion about the editing portion because she's the expert here, and I'm not very good at making videos, so she definitely could have helped me with some of the editing, but overall, it turned out pretty good. What I got from this project, I definitely gained a lot of confidence in my research abilities, learned how to use a new computer software program. I also became a lot more passionate about spreading the word and talking to people about it, and like I said, I received a lot of positive feedback. So how my project could help in the future, I think that the students who were able to see my video are definitely now knowledgeable about the dangers of fentanyl, and it allows them to make better decisions as they, you know, transition through high school and college. My video can also be shown in future health classes. I'm definitely hoping that it'll become a part of the curriculum because it is so important, and I feel like it's something that's just not talked about enough. And obviously my biggest hope is someday it won't have to be talked about. I'd like to give a special thank you to Amy Leone. She was my first mentor, like I said, and she helped me with some of the research-based stuff in the beginning. Mr. Finney for using my class, Ms. Phil Brown for helping me overcome some obstacles when I was unsure of things, my parents for being so supportive, and I didn't throw it in there, but Mr. Bigelow and Andrew for Senior Project Day. I thought that was a really good opportunity to share my interpreted. Any questions?